So I have only about 15 minutes for the future of learning. That's very tough. So let's start right here. Who knows this guy? Probably Silicon Valley Bank. It's the Elon Musk of education, Sal Khan. Very quickly, he holds several degrees of MIT, was a famous investment banker, and then educated his cousin via YouTube in 2006, 2007. And because it goes went viral, he said, "Oh, I'm a little bit have a little bit expectation in software. I write a little program, and I rush a little bit." He is funded by Bill Gates Foundation, Google, and is now running a nonprofit organization, and it's called the Worldwide Classroom Khan Academy. And he says, "I believe that the way we teach and learn is at a turning point that we experience only once in 1,000 years, not in 100 or 200, like the printing press, like in 1,000 years. And when those guys say this, it will have an impact on every industry, on every company, every individual, CEO, CMO, whatever." And that's a fact, and that's my part. In 2010, I was studying mathematics. And was running my first little local startup with on-site learning courses. And on a Sunday evening, I discovered YouTube, not for cat videos or gaming, but for MIT courses, 1 hour and a half for free. And I was wondering, hell, it's so easy learning with tutorials on YouTube that could be a thing and that could also help my company, my little startup, when the students have questions. So I started to produce content, and I thought 1 hour and a half is too long. Let's do it in nuggets. So I produced 5 to 10 minute videos, just with topics like differential equations, all the beauty, fractions, and so. And I used YouTube because you can reach out very quickly, many viewers who give you the feedback, and if it would have been shit, they would have told me, but it was not so bad, and I produced more and more and more. Since 2011, I have been producing 2,500 videos. That allows me to put a single video via YouTube into a playlist, so you can start from scratch with differential equation, with video one, and after 10 videos, tonight after Bar Reingold, you do the course, and you're a pro in differential equations. And I put all those playlists into categories. So we heard it's all about statistics. So you can do the statistics stuff, begin from scratch with the first playlist, second, and it's only videos, not much more. No question, no answers, just videos. What happened? Every single video is in German, and I'm now at 130 million views. 100 million in the last 2 years, so it's exponential growth. Often I'm asked, video learning, could that be something? I say, yes, look at the counts. At the best day, I had 1.5 million views watching all those tutorials. I'm now at 300,000 new followers every year. So I can do the crazy stuff. The Superman picture was created and sent to me by a mother with a long letter. "Thank you, Daniel, because you made it possible that me and my husband can learn with my children. We don't have much money, so we can't afford extra courses. And here it's all for free, and I have my personal tutor. I'm not the only one. It's like the new rock stars are after gaming, beauty, fashion, now education. It's RWTH Aachen. When I visit RWTH Aachen, we celebrate mathematics. It's a Technical University of Vienna, where I have to sign skateboards for mathematics students. So it's really a hype that people love mathematics because it's very simple, it's very clean, just videos for free, on demand, in nuggets. Now I can get back, be a little bit more serious. I reach out very much very a crowd with students, so I can talk now to them. What's the single most important thing you need to know about mathematics? It's exponential growth. We are now at a tipping point where in shorter times, much more is happening, and it's combinatorial. It's all those things, geoengineering, exponential data economy, artificial intelligence, et cetera, et cetera. You have to deal with it, whether you are an entrepreneur, whether you're a student. So we have to radically change the whole system because all is based on the industrial age. And now everything is changing. So it's not all about video learning. 4 years ago, two students in Paderborn wrote to me via Facebook, Daniel, everyone is learning with your videos. Would you come to Paderborn? We have a business idea. I said, okay, to my car, new business idea. And they said, we do on-site offline courses, 3 days to pass an exam. No digital, just on-site. Said, oh yes, we tested it. And now after 4 years, we have about 800 courses in 200 cities in Germany and Austria. It's all based on 3 days with a tutor going all into your head and pass an exam. Not only mathematics. You can argue it's not the best way, but it is a business model where you could build new things around it. So we developed, you see it there, exercise books. In these exercise books, we put on QR codes. Death the QR code, long live the QR code. Because if you have a question, you go in and come into my video. So we are testing there now. They are just buying the books, not going to the courses. They use the exercise books, and we track who is going into a video. So what's the combination there? It's an offline product with directly on demand jump into a video. Meanwhile, 4 years ago, I'm a crazy guy, so I put a whole money into real estate because I thought, oh, those co-working spaces could be something. I think co-learning spaces could be something. So I created a co-learning space focused on students. Crashed horrible. Went roughly bankrupt. So I switched the model to co-working, focused on mid-sized companies. But I used the experience, with the company StudyHelp I've co-founded. And now we open co-learning spaces in Paderborn, where you come together and we try to switch the teacher from teacher to mentor. So you come together in small groups, in a nice environment, and the mentor helps you finding stuff on the internet, pass an exam. It's testing. We raised money last year to push that forward because schools and universities don't go that way. Crazy, a whole new thing that 5 years ago, if you talked about co-working spaces, everyone was asking, what is co-working space? Now, yesterday, we spent some time at Scaling Spaces. You might be familiar with WeWork. It's raising up, and 5 years ahead, we have co-learning spaces all over the world. Back to digital, because I'm learning a lot from feedback. We mentioned Udacity, Coursera. So I'm taking my stuff, my videos, combining them with tests, multiple choices, solutions, and build my own digital platform just to learn from the feedback. Is that something for you? Who is learning when? Are you dealing with, I even need an on-site course? I don't know. That's all about testing. So with all the feedback, the clearest point was, I need an app for a specific math question and get the answer. So last week, I hired two developers to say, I need a new database because 1.5 million views on one day on YouTube, they got all the traction, all the information to sell ads. I say, I need all the information in my environment, specific on when does someone ask what question, what answer does he get, and it's all about human interaction. So I tested it 4-5 weeks ago, very roughly on WordPress. And I have 1,300 users signed in. learners and tutors who are helping each other. It's like if someone is familiar with Stack Overflow, you know Stack Overflow, 50 million developers who are helping each other. It goes in this direction. I'm focusing this on math. You will have profiles, a chat is very clear, you will be matched, and coming to data and AI, I will use it only to track when do you do what question, what answer do you get. It's all about testing. So learning future skills, because all is coming together combinatorial, I started a project with Fraunhofer IAIS. It's all about data. It's a very well-known company. And they have a project, Roberta Initiative. And they have an open Roberta lab. They programmed NEPO, so you can learn per drag and drop what's this coding stuff. You don't need to code. You learn to interact with it. We produced videos on demand to give you an help if you say, oh, this video thing is something, help me, where should I drag, where should I do what? And they do offline courses. And again, they are mixing it all together. Offline, online, video learning with new topics, because the future is Internet of Things, data-driven, connected devices, how do we help our kids? This is all for free. So there are some business models, good, and there are shitty busy models like YouTube. So I don't earn a lot of money with YouTube. And I have to think about what's the future right here? It's online, offline in combination. You have to deal with new skills. It's on demand, it's individual, small units, it's collaborative. And how can I push it forward? How can I shape the future? For me, if you ask me, what are you doing? So I'm not the classical guy running one company. For me, it's all about, I have this shitty B2C market, because when it comes to education and earning money, you don't want to pay much money for education, because right here in Germany, it's all for free. It has to be for free. So I have to have cash from somewhere. So I'm running a consulting business, focused B2B, where I help companies implement new learning features, skills, whatever. I took those money always to give stuff for free, like the YouTube videos, like the free chat now, and I try to build around it some business models and implement it. In my universe, I call it B2I because I'm running this. Is anyone familiar with Gary Vaynerchuk from America? We had this discussion in the board. How can you push forward marketing? I do those Gary Vaynerchuk, so I can highly recommend to deal with it, because he is filming all what he's doing. I'm not only filming my math videos, I'm now filming, Chris is running somewhere here, he is filming that I'm here in Berlin, I'm not skateboarding through Berlin, but I'm doing all those stuff about new learning, what projects do I do, and I push it via YouTube, Facebook, everywhere out, with some kind of lecturing. I'm telling my crowd, now I'm in Berlin, it's all about entrepreneurship, it's all about new learning, what can you do, startup, all this startup thing is something, perhaps I do an interview with Tobias Church yesterday from Contorion. Do you have any advices for my crowd? So it's all for free, pushing out, like the math videos, all for free, pushing out. And like the mother is sending me those long letters, thank you, thank you, thank you. Then I could create those brand, Daniel Jung, the education guy, and then in the video, perhaps pushing up, if you have any math question, go to my app. Boom, going to the app in a few days. And that's all the kind of, how can you market? And I think it's like kind of a blueprint for the modern CNO, CEO. It's not for every CEO, but if you look at Elon Musk, yeah, at April the 1st, he lies with a beer and I'm bankrupty. With Tesla, all are laughing, but the tweets on Twitter are going around and he's doing marketing for Tesla. So it's all kind of, I'm doing the marketing guy with my brand for myself, pushing it all out with education first. And that's why I created a little education startup accelerator, because I have many requests. I want to start something in education. Can you help me? What can you do for me? So if it is a nice idea, I can go into it with my brand. I can do the acceleration about my YouTube channel, about all my channels, or about all my social media, and push it out. And perhaps I'm a founding partner, or I put money in it. So it's all focused on education and new learning solutions. That's my best buddy, that's my nephew. So as an entrepreneur, I'm looking at him. He is 1 year old. So how will he learn in 5, 10, and 15 years? Where will he learn? What will he learn? Because the standardized system right now has crashed. And how can we shape this future? I think there will be some rocket guys like me who push every money coming in out into new solutions, giving stuff for free, building, testing around it, having sleepless nights, gray hairs, because the developers didn't want shares, so I give them money. So I'm looking, what can I do with it? And like Elon Musk is shaping the future of mobility, we have to need more guys who are shaping the future of learning, which isn't a combination of online, offline, nugget learning, focused, the data, AI needs focused data. So YouTube is not the solution, not the answer, because the data when it comes to learning is at YouTube, Google. So you have to build new solutions, and there will be new solutions. It's a big market, it's a huge market. As an entrepreneur, if you want to be a part of some Udacity, Coursera, if you have an idea and you are afraid of starting a startup, go to Udacity, Coursera, or whatever, because we need more people into this education thing, shaping the future. And that's what I'm looking for this little guy, to shape it, to build new stuff. And that's not only videos, but it's all those ecosystem around all my on-site learning courses, all those things happening in the cloud, the videos, the marketing, all is coming together with a focus on education. It's a very hard life, because education is very hard to revolutionize, to disrupt, because education. And I know the talks about, hey, at WHU, let's produce videos. Let's start now. It's all about starting. We talked about it. How can we target? We have a good product, but what should we do? Start to produce videos right now. Give something for free outside, and they will say, "Oh, you are so nice. What do you have instead?" But everyone is worried about, what could I do with it? Why should I give it for free? But you have the best network. You have quality in courses. You have good people. So that's roughly coming together right now. Rocket guys on the internet, giving stuff for free, building new things. And I hope I can do my part further on. Thank you very much.